Good afternoon. It's the 27th of January, almost 1 month of the year gone out of 12, obviously. And this is the 27th of January, approaching 2 p.m. here in Christchurch, New Zealand. Another lovely day outside. Yesterday I was going through the match game number one with Morphy is white and Anderson is black, which occurred in Paris, not Times Square in New York, but in Paris on the December 20, 1858, and Morphy is white and he actually lost this first round game. And so I'm going to go over it again because I didn't finish it yesterday. I got into time trouble. And the result of this actual match was Morphy 7, Anderson 2, and 2 draws. So 1 out of 2 for the 2 draws. And so they had 11 games. So obvious, from the title, I'm David Wegener. That's a Dutch name, Wegener. And so anyway, this is that game that was played all those years ago. As I said yesterday, this is considered a serious strategical error, says Steintz, William Steintz, costing a pawn and bringing his bishop out of play. So White's putting their bishop on the a1 to h8 file, and there's two pawns in the way of their scope, what they get to look at. What Morphy feared in reply to bishop to king 3 was pawn to bishop 3. This he wishes to meet with Bishop to rook 3, as otherwise he gets a Morphy's dilemma. As otherwise he gets a hopelessly bad pawn formation. Morphy's dilemma shows the soundness of Anderson's judgment on move 10, which we've already gone past move 10, which was castles for black. So we'll go here. Could move it, say it's for white, pawn to bishop 4 or f4. Check. Not much else than that, check. To defend this f-pawn, f7 pawn for black. Could move according to the book. White's sort of threatening this, and rook takes pawn check, because other than the threatening the rook as well, but threatening that rook takes pawn check, and then knight takes is the only sensible move, but it's no good. There's a queen takes queen on c6 for white. So white's also threatening queen f5. That's Morphy, by the way, playing white. I've just lost my spot, that's all. Trying to find my spot. I was over there somewhere, wasn't I? It's quite a long game, actually. It took the players 7 hours, this game. And white resigns, which is Morphy. So this is one of the two games he lost. I'm just trying to find my spot, but the thing is that my eyes are that great. I can hardly, I'm used to the other. I think I've done this wrong again. I don't understand why I can do it. Rook to queen 6. Don't know where I'm up to. So I'm trying to find where I got with my queen bishop 5. There's the queen on bishop 5. A rook behind it. Not having much luck with this book. It's like my eyes just don't. It's like I'm not used to the algebra, the descriptive anymore. Although you'd think so, because I'm. It's just like you've got to watch the kings and the rooks, because they're so, and the bishops, because they're so close. When you've got sort of bad eyes. I'm getting there. Rook. Here we go. King's rook to queen 1. Sorry for the wait. Queen to bishop 6. Like I said, white can threaten this now. Bishop 5 and bishop 6. Queen bishop 5 and queen bishop 6. To my eyes, look very similar. So that's just removing that wee nasty pun of rook takes pawn check, knight takes rook on g7, queen takes queen on c6, thereby white wins material. Or gets a checkmate very, very soon after. So if white gets to play this, it's checkmate after, if the king moves, after king f8, it's queen f7 mate. After king h7, I mean king h8, it's queen h6 mate. I'm gonna get my reading glasses. Hold on, please. Right. That's better, sort of. It's still pretty Gritty, the now why is the queen back on c6 again? I don't understand that. Oh, okay, that's, I went there. Queen, yes, I thought it was that. They gave this as a bad move. All of a sudden, Black's unleashed with an attack on the F pawn to watch out for. Now that's an odd move. Didn't see that coming. Queen takes pawn. King took one. Knight to king four. And if rook takes knight or rook e4, I don't know. Probably queen e6. Defending the knight at the same time is attacking this pawn here. Notice that they can't go here, of course, for check. All there, all there. They can go there, but it's not advised. They can go queen check here, but then the king can just move up to h7, and then it's hard for white to find another pawn to another pawn or king to check, or pawn to attack or something like that. Whereas the e pawn for white is in danger. Now, by the way, I'm just thinking about what Anatoly Karpov says or said to a lot of juniors now when they asked how can we improve our game, because they said, well, we're really good at the openings and all that sort of thing. And Karpov's reply was, study the end game. Now, that's what we're sort of doing now without actually me saying we're going to study the end game. But that's what we're actually doing here right now. And it's all very well being able to outbook someone, but also you have to be able to play the game of chess as well. And so if you learn the end game, you can learn the difficulties and the intricacies and everything like that, but you can also learn the simplicities of it as well. Because some of it can be simple, but some of it can appear to be simple, but it can be really, really difficult to find any sort of play. that defends you or moves forward or whatever the case may be. Runaway pawn, runaway pawn. Now that's sort of forcing white's hand, black's hand a wee bit, because it threatens queen g8 mate. It threatens that, yep, nothing else. So, Anderson takes the knight. Now we're coming to the end. As white cannot here capture the bishop pawn, obviously, because of queen c4 check, he might have resigned at once. The game, however, did continue, so I was incorrect, with king e1. Pawn to c5 or c5, queen to knight 7, king to bishop 5, queen to bishop 7 check, king to c3. Queen to f3 check. Queen d3, queen f6 check, king to knight 6, queen to knight 6 check, king to bishop 7, and now we've got the same sort of situation, a little bit different. With queen takes c5 check, queen c7 check, queen takes queen. I'll show you. And that the pawn just runs all the way. And White resigned. That's the end of the session. Soon I might have a look if there's a quick one to play. But I'll tick that one off because... And today... today I repaired my plumbing. And I was going to pay this morning a plumber detective to come around and fix it for me, but that would have been about $80 for the call out fee and then their travel time and blah blah blah, and they were only going to stop my tap from as soon as I turn it on at the what's called the Toby box in the front of the property of mine. As soon as I turn that on, they could stop this tap from running, okay? And so, but what happened was, is that it was a bit of a long story, believe it or not, because I know, I kid you not, but it was a bit of a long story that, all I had to do was basically put a cork or stop the pipe from having the water falling out of it and flooding the house. So anyway, I got the thing all sorted and it's for free, and so other things are happening too, so it's pretty good. Okay, so now if White takes this pawn here, then Black has this queen check, and that forces the queen takes, king takes, and pawn up to here, etc. Okay, thank you very much.